I'm going to be talking in English for this presentation. I'm Ranulfo Bezerra, and I'm going to be presenting the multi-robot task allocation and pathfinding in Industry 6.0. And before I start, I'm going to, in this presentation, I'm going to explain about garment as a use case, so a garment industry as a use case. So in the garment manufacturing, is most common to be used in mass production. So mass production, it has several issues. As you can see in here, there are three main ones, and I'm going to explain why. The enormous environmental impact that is caused on the mass production relevant to the art. For example, for washing the clothes and treating the clothes, you can spend 100, you have an equivalent of one garbage truck full of clothes is kind of burned every day because there is too much clothes being produced. There is an average of 1,300 tons of clothes that are incinerated on landfill in Japan. And there is a fashion industry that is responsible for 8 to 10% of the humanity's carbon emission, according to UN. So a lack of variety of this production of clothes kind of generates a large quantity of the same type of clothes being produced over and over again. So many of those customers, they want a personalized production, but mostly there is, in mass production, it is just one type specific or one size or one specific type of fabric. So there is a huge inventory buildup, which produces that cannot be sold. And then this excess of inventory requires a large amount of warehouse space, which you need to expend resources, energy, and so on. So in order to think about a sustainable future, addressing those issues is required. And in order to do this, I would like to introduce transformer production. So transformer production, as I'm going to try to explain as Industry 6.0 and why, it's first, as you can see, mass production, which you have a line of customers. You have one line to produce one type of cloth specifically, and that requires an amount of people working on them. And then if you start moving to transformer production or Industry 5.0, in that case, you start to having some robots working together. So this is mostly Industry 5.0, as you can see here. Some static robots, some people working, all of them do not share space, and they have all their own areas to be working. But then if we want to move to 6.0 and move to have this transformer production, you need to be able to enable production of multiple types of garments, so a personalized industry. But how to do that specifically is the challenge. So, okay, you have spaces, you have people, but just one line of people can do that? Or do you need multiple lines for each type of clothes? So in order to address that, we want to have multiple mobile robots to work on the transportation of clothes in order to have an intelligent manufacturing environment. So in order to do that, we have a layout that it can be definable, adaptable to any circumstances. And ensuring this transportation, we have those mobile robots that will be in charge of transporting each cloth from one place to the other so that it can ensure that the production of one set of clothes is done. But of course, since you have robots working with people, we need to understand everything that is happening here, not just that the robot has one job, but what is the job of the people, what is happening in the scenery, and there is this connection that requires advanced IoT devices that can monitor both the workers and the whole environment, so that nothing happens without being planned. So a bit of overview of both of them. So like transformer production can drastically reduce the resources and the variety of production. So as you can see, one mass production, the four lines of production just to produce four different types of gloves, where in one specific line, adaptable, we can produce multiple types of gloves in one scenery. So in order to enable that specifically, in this research, I'm going to explain three factors that requires that to happen. So in order to summarize, we have the customer's orders, which will happen online specifically. So everyone is going to be receiving orders over and over. So depending on each order is a specific type of clothes, specific color, specific size, and so on. So those orders are processed and they compose into tasks, which some tasks will be responsible for different types of workers or robots and so on. And then who is going to be in charge of transporting those will be the mobile robots. So in here, we require a very intelligent task allocator that is able to understand which order is happening, the composition of the orders, and be able to effectively allocate the tasks for each robot. And while dealing with mobile robots, it is extremely important to have a path finding. So a way of the robot to find the path between point A to point B without hitting any other robot or obstacle in the way. And in order for the robot to do the pathfinding, it is also required for it to know where is point A, where is point B, and where am I. So having to have a SLAM, a simultaneous localization and mapping system. So in the case of in this transformer production, the SLAM also needs to be changeable, needs to be adaptable. So in these years, we have done those three types of research that I'm going to be talking a little bit. So for example, the layout SLAM++ that I'll be explaining, it is able to find where the robot is, find where the objects and workstations are, and also classify which types of working stations are those with 94% of precision, and this SLAM have improved 5% from the last time. We have developed an online deep reinforcement learning scheduler that improves the mixed spanning 12%. And we have a multi-robot pathfinding that is able to not only understand where each robot needs to go specifically, but it takes into consideration the deadline of the whole order in the system. So a little bit of an explanation of the layout SLAM. So as I told you, it is important for us to understand where is the point A and point B. So having to understand point A and point B means that I need to understand what are those working stations, where they are, and where should the robot deliver and pick up the products. So based on that, for example, if the layout changes, it needs to determine where it is. In this presentation, I'm not specifically explaining how the layout plus plus happened, but I'm gonna be jumping up a bit to explain the task allocation. So the task allocation in here, online specifically, we have several steps required for it to happen. So for example, as I explained, the order needs to be generated. So the orders come from simulated from the transformer production. So when someone orders, these orders are gonna be processed into tasks. So each task is gonna be coming to one of those origin, one of those types, which is outstanding queue, ready queue, executable queue, and completed queue. So it always goes to a workflow depending specifically of the graph that is generated for each glove. And of course, each glove has a different type of graph. So based on that, in the system, the tasks are ready, which means that it is able to process them in the specific time. They can be scheduled or can be rescheduled if they are already ready. So in order to have done that, we have developed a deep reinforcement learning that receives those ready tasks. As I can see, like each ready task, it doesn't have anything allocated. So I put like a white square in here so that you can understand.
And then there's also the executable tests that have already the resource that are being allocated to it. But however, they are executable tasks. They are not being executed or not allocated. So they can be still rescheduled. So based on that, we have a deep reinforcement learning that for every time step, it understands what is the observation state, which means everything that is happening in the factory, in the scenario, in that specific time. And then it will reallocate or allocate the tasks of both the executable and the ready tasks as soon as they have that scenario. So we develop a tailor-made deep reinforcement learning and a smart allocator that directs the tasks to the right resource. And that had us with this high performance that I explained before. So for our multi-agent pickup and delivery, we have developed one multi-agent pickup and delivery that usually those pathfinding algorithms, they have, they only take into consideration what the mobile robot and all the mobile robots are doing and going to the specific time. But this one we have developed so that when something like this happens, which is a conflict between three robots, the one that is gonna be stopping, which you saw with the yellow one, is not just related to the exact deadline right now of the robot to finish its task, but is also gonna be taking into consideration the whole order scenario. So if I have an order that it doesn't not need to be done right now, it can wait for the older robots. So it takes is an extension of windowed conflict-based search. So in here, you'll be able to see one video that shows this integration of both task allocation and mobile robot pathfinding. So in the top corner, you see that we have the schedule where we have static tasks and mobile tasks happening in the specific scenario. And in there, you see a pickup happening where the pickup shows the robot goes and does the delivery for the assembly agents too, which is exactly shown in the schedule on the top. After doing that, the agent two receives the other process, which was in there. So here's a very simple type of task, just three tasks. And then the assembly agent is gonna finish its task. And after it finishes, it means that the order two have happened to 100%. So it means that it finished its order. So that all simple example, just to explain how it's the process. I'd like to thank you for the presentation.